there, good afternoon. You're watching Proactive London and joining us today from MetalNRG, it is of course Rolf Gerritsen and Pierpaolo Rocco today, the both of you. How are you both?
Very well, Katie. How are you?
I'm doing well, thank you very much. Considering it's January, we're in lockdown, but doing well.
So happy New Year. Belated, but happy New Year.
Exactly. Happy New Year. So let's maybe kickstart this off with Rolf and explain the abandonment of the Lake Victoria gold transaction, if you could.
Yeah, look, Lake Victoria gold, we spent quite a bit of time on it, and we were initially extremely keen on the transaction in that it offered potentially a good upside and a good entry into gold in Africa. And more importantly, it was presented to us as being very close to production. We looked at it in great detail, and one of the aspects that transpired quite rapidly was that one of the options that LVG had wasn't in such strong standing. That meant that we were at risk of losing about 90,000 ounces of gold. Mm-hmm. Due to the fact that as a board, we've established some very stringent criteria that we use to tick our investments off against, the governance was just not there in terms of the proposition from LVG with the loss of that option. Was just, the financials were just not strong enough. Mm-hmm. What it also meant in our opinion was that the risk of us having to financially support LVG for a longer period of time than just a year to get them into production was quite high. And as a result, we've decided to abandon the transaction and walk away from it, in that it just didn't offer the value that originally we had hoped it would. And the dilution that it would take our shareholders through was just not worth the upside that we saw in the medium to the longer term. And therefore we moved on.
Okay. Well, let's now move on ourselves. We'll stick with you, Rolf, for now, and we will talk about Sunswept Enterprises, because this transaction is now complete.
Yes, and Pierpaolo has done an excellent job with his team, and we're delighted to take our first steps into oil and gas, and Pierpaolo is probably the best to take you through the detail.
Pierpaolo, let's get you into the fold now and get your technical expertise in this sector. So maybe explain this transaction to us and how you plan to maybe reap the benefits here.
Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you. The Rolf stressed the fact of we have a good team, and I believe we haven't enough brought that point into evidence so far. Indeed, the team is one of our secret weapons that delivered a deal which otherwise wouldn't have been an easy deal to finalize. Well, that said, I'm not saying it was an easy one, but, it took some time to get on top of all the elements, all the subjects that we needed to, to understand better, and all the relationships that we needed to realign a little bit. But it's really a great team that we have, massive experience in this team. We've got really, really great names, and we'll disclose all the names in a very short term when we launch the website. But the other thing that actually made this team possible was a little bit our strategy. And our strategy was to have the team invested and therefore motivated in achieving certain things. And the great thing though is also that we don't, that also helped keeping the fixed costs down. Our overheads are very minimal, so we don't have an element of overheads, comparable to any other oil company, even larger, obviously, in our more or less competitive background, we keep our costs much lower. So that allowed us to, because obviously we reward our team in a different way. So that's a big differentiator that we have. So it's not only about share options. Our team have a significant investment, be personally, directly invested in the business, and their investment is meaningful. So, that said, that was a little bit of an enabler, allowing certain things to happen, certain activities to be carried out with a minimum spend and excellent results. So that was that happened. Then what are we going to do next with this team? Well, the we have a plan, we have a precise, more or less precise plan. By the way, we discussed earlier today with DOJ what we're going to do in the future more in detail. It was a great discussion. So there's total openness on our side to disclose what we plan to do within, obviously, the obvious the remit of the confidentiality, because clearly we do live in a competitive environment. There is an element of confidentiality that we need to keep, even with our investors. But the but it's clear that we are focusing on the on these assets. These are the assets that we have as potential. So we've been in previous interviews have been saying we're going to do more. We want to do more. Yes, but we do. We also plan to do as much as we possibly can with what we have, and we see. It's an asset that at the moment is producing, and like I said, one well is shut in, unfortunately, but we're talking about 35,000 plus barrels a year, we're pretty confident within Q1, we will restate the bare minimum level of productivities, and that's the range. And but with a few interventions that we are planning to do within the year, we are planning to exceed, 150,000 barrels. And I'm saying that with a P50 confidence level. So that means that we can, there is potential with what we are doing, and the potential is not negligible, certainly not for an operation of this size. And yes, that will enable, hopefully soon, other activities and benefits. But what we have at the moment, and I would like to stress that, it's meaningful. So this was a significant step. It wasn't just, we call it a stepping stone because we're looking to do more, but it's an important step. It's really the key to enable all the other steps in our strategy. Without this, so this has been a great achievement. Mm-hmm.
A key stepping stone for you, clearly. Now you've sort of gone through some of the attributes here. You're controlling the cost here. You're clearly very proud of your management team. You're going to be coming out with some names very shortly indeed. I'm sure there's some grand credentials on that list. Maybe Rolf, let's get your take, shall we, on this one, and just sort of follow on from what Pierpaolo has said there.
Well, I think the structure with which we invested was interesting, because MetalNRG owns 50% of the BritNRG company that owns the assets. The balance is held by private investors who are part of the management team, and the people have put in a significant stake, and we are all aligned towards achieving the same objective, and I think that's quite unique. And it also allows us to rely on levels of experience, which maybe we would not have originally attracted to this kind of an asset. So again, great stepping stone with huge potential in a relatively short period of time without necessarily massive investments.
Sounds good. Rolf Gerritsen there and Pierpaolo Rocco here on Proactive London this afternoon.
Thank you very much.
Great. Thank you.